Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today we are going to learn about the Nearctic region. Nearctic and Neotropical region is called the New World. And why we call Nearctic and Neotropical region New World? The reason is that because before the discovery of Americas, it was believed that there is only three continents in the world, namely Europe, Asia, and Africa. When Columbus discovered the Americas and he called the Neotropical and Nearctic region New World, and Asia, Europe, and Africa collectively known as the Old World. After the discovery of the Columbus, Asia, Europe, and Africa is known as Old World, and Neotropical and Nearctic region is called as a New World. As we discussed in the previous lecture, that while we study the zoogeographic region, we focus on three important points. The first one is the geographic limit. The second one is the physical features. And in physical features, we have to discuss the climatic conditions and ecological conditions. And at the end, the most important thing of the region is the final feature of the region. First, the geographic range of the region. The Nearctic region is also known as the North American region, and you can also see the Nearctic region in the map. The light greenish area represents the Nearctic region, and the countries included in the Nearctic region is Greenland. Greenland is the world's largest island located between the Arctic and Atlantic Ocean. And the second one is the Central Florida. And Central Florida is the state of US. And the next is Mexico. Mexico is a country in the southern portion of the North America. It is bordered to the north by United States, to the south and west by the Pacific Ocean. And part of North America that are not included in the Nearctic region is Eastern Mexico, Southern and Central Florida, Central America, and Caribbean Island. The all side of the Nearctic region is covered with sea. Only connection, land connection, is the Isthmus of Panama that connects the Nearctic region to the Neotropical region. Isthmus of Panama is the narrow land connection that connects the Nearctic region with Neotropical region. Next is the physical feature of the region. Like Palearctic region, this region also have extreme cold and hot climate and have diversity in climatic conditions. The Greenland is entirely Arctic. In northern portion, the winter temperature is very lower than found in the corresponding latitude in Europe. Life is very scarce in this region, as few animal can survive in frozen soil. Here is the different habitats of the region that range from Arctic tundra, evergreen forest, grasslands, and desert. Here are some ecoregions of the Nearctic realm. And ecoregion is an ecologically and geographically defined area that is smaller than a bioregion. Ecoregion covers relatively large areas of land and water and contain characteristic geographically distinct assemblage of natural communities and species. And the ecoregions that are present in this realms is the Canadian Shield, Eastern North America, Northern Mexico, and Western North America. These are four different ecoregions that are included in Nearctic realm. Now we will discuss the final feature of the region. And in this region, there are 120 family of the terrestrial vertebrates are present, and 14 amphibian families, 21 reptilian families, 59 birds families are present, and 26 mammalian families are located in this region. Now, the mammals of Nearctic regions. Nearctic regions have some animals that are present in the Palearctic regions. It includes the beaver, mole, pikas, and jumping mice. And some species across the Neotropical to the North America are the marsupials such as opossum, shrew opossum, nine-banded armadillo, and tree porcupine. And there are the some mammal of wide-ranging distribution, namely shrews, rabbits, squirrels, mice, cats, bats, bears, deers, and bovids. These are the species that have wide-ranging distribution. Nearctic region mammals, here you can see the pictures of the some animals that is present in Neotropical region as well. And the name of and name and pictures of these animals are given in the slide: opossum, armadillo, picari, and tree porcupine. These are the animals that are also present in the Neotropical region. And here are some animals that are present in the Neotropical regions: is the rabbits, squirrels, chrysidid, rat, mice, dogs, mustelids, and cats and bats. And the endemic mammals of the Nearctic region, there are two families that are endemic to this region: is the antilo, carpridae, and Aplodontidae. And the examples that are included in Antilocarpididae is pronghorn, and the example of the Aplodontidae is the mountain beaver or civet. There are a large number of the endemic rodents. These includes the wood rats, 17 species of the ground squirrels, three antelope squirrels, 16 chipmunks, 10 squirrels and flying squirrels, 12 pocket gophers, and 37 species of the heteromyrid rodents. And the characteristic larger endemic species like bison, bighorn sheeps, and thin-horn sheeps are also present in this region. Here you can see the pictures of the some endemic mammals, civet and pronghorn. These two mammals are endemic to this region. Endemic animals are those when a species is found only in a particular geographic region because of its isolation, soil, and climatic condition, it is said to be endemic. So these two animals are endemic, or you can say native to this region. And next is the pocket gophers and the pocket mice, that is endemic. These two animals are endemic, also endemic to this region. The next is the reptiles. There are turtles, non-poisonous garter snakes, rattlesnakes, jacus, horned lizard, limbless lizard, horned toad, and alligators. And Gila monster is exclusive to this region. Annelidae is the endemic family of the region. Here you can see the picture of some reptiles: snapping turtles, musk turtles, and terrapins. These are the pictures of some animals that are present in this region. Here you can see the exclusive Nearctic species, that is Gila monster. This is a poisonous lizard, and the endemic genus of the land tortoise, gophers. This species is also endemic to this region. And here is the picture of the some typical Nearctic lizard that are not confined, or you can say these species are not endemic species. And this species includes the jackus, horned ignite lizards, and skinks. These two species of the snakes are also not endemic, or you can say it is not confined to this region. And the examples are the garter snakes and the rattlesnake. Next is a bird of the Nearctic region. There are 49 families of the bird in this region, out of which 39 are widely distributed. Camidae is the endemic family of the region. And exclusive birds are the wild turkey, red cardinals, hummingbirds, tanagers, and white turkeys, and golden plover migrates from Europe. And here is the exclusive bird, wild turkey. This bird is only present in this region. Mostly bird fauna is show similarity, or you can say affinity, with the neotropical region. Only few species, you can say this wild turkey is endemic to this region. Mostly bird fauna is similar to the neotropical region. Here, similarity with the neotropical regions, there are some birds which are also present in the neotropical region, is the bright red cardinals, tanagers, and hummingbirds. Next is amphibians. If we talk about the amphibians, mostly uridales is present in this region. As you know that uridale is the order of the amphibians, and in uridales, tailed amphibians are included in this order. Like salamanders, halberders, eel-like siren, the Congo eel, and tiger salamander. Newts included the smooth newt, great crested newt, banded newts, alpine newts, bosca newts. And there are the dusky salamanders and red-black salamanders and Jordan salamanders are also included in this region. Serenidae is the endemic family. Here you can see the picture of some tailed amphibians, or you can say uridales, eastern red salamanders, and biostoma species and the siren species. As I already told you that mostly uridales are common in the Nearctic regions. Next is the fishes of the Palearctic regions. There are many carps in the perches, and holistae are endemic that include only two surviving ganoid fishes, one species of the bowfin found in America lakes, and the seven species of the garp-like found in the American rivers. And these species possess the sharp teeth to seize and gulp prey with extraordinary swiftness, and the paddle fish occur in the Mississippi River of the America and represents the chondrosity. Here you can see the picture of the American carp and yellow perch. And here is, you can see the some endemic families like bowfin, garp-like. These are the fishes that is endemic to this region. And at the end, we will discuss affinity. It is unique in having the animal accent which are present in the neighboring region. No camel present from the neighboring region. There is no hedgehog or hyenas from the Palearctic region. No tapirs from the Oriental region. And no family show discontinuous distribution. Birds are less different from neighboring regions, rich in reptiles compared to the Palearctic and Neotropical regions.